This trip to the countryside will be good for you, Holmes.
Hmm.
As your friend and your doctor, I really do recommend that you give yourself a complete change of scene. Fresh air, brisk walks, bird watching, chopping wood.
Sounds intolerant. I mean, certainly it sounds delightful.
But you haven't yet told me who your friend is, the one we're going to visit.
He is a bee lover.
A bee lover? Do you mean that he keeps bees? That must be Mrs. Hudson, bringing the warm cloth that I requested.
There is someone to see you, Mr. Holmes.
I have no time. Send whoever it is away.
Yes, Holmes, I really think we ought to leave now.
Mycroft.
Sherlock.
Mr. Holmes? Perhaps you don't remember me. I'm Dr. Watson. We met at the Diogenes Club a few years ago. I documented our encounter in a short story I gave the title The Greek Interpreter.
He does remember you, Watson. My brother remembers everything, and that is why he is so valuable to the government.
We are about to depart for the train station.
I know.
You know?
Sherlock, I need your help. There are people who presently threaten both our country and the Crown itself. You must help us with those methods of yours.
Need? Help? Those are not words I would readily associate with you, Mycroft.
I wrote you a letter, but you did not reply. And this is not about politics. It's about people. People similar to those whom you pretend to defend in your petty detective affairs.
Everything is about politics with you, Mycroft. I'm not interested. Have some of your agents, your spies, or worse, undertake this job of yours. You are defending your people, and they have little to do with the people I choose to help, I can assure you.
That is the point. You think exactly as they do.
Who are they?
The Merry Men. He is talking about the Merry Men, a band of idealistic terrorists.
Sherlock, do please think about it. They are planning something diabolical. Your country needs you.
You need me, Mycroft, and you are not the country. Although if your waistline expands very much further...
Mrs. Hudson, tea will not be necessary. Dr. Watson, the train conductor, Mr. Parker, is aware that you will be 7 minutes late. You are in the fourth car. The train will be waiting for you. Sherlock, enjoy your time in Staffordshire. And do, please, at least write to me on your return.
Holmes, please call a cab while I pack my suitcase. We should be late for the train.
Look after Mrs. Hudson for us, Toby. Look after Mrs. Hudson for us, Toby. Watson, I'll hold a cab for us. We leave in 5 minutes for the station.
Brr, what a gloomy night. It was warmer inside the waiting hall.
Since the station master told us that the train is about to arrive, we should not have to wait very much longer.
Yes, at last.
Attention! The train is arriving at the station. Please stand well away from the platform edge.
I'll take your bags and your blasted archive suitcase. But, Holmes, the headlight. It's faded away.
Something is wrong. I can't hear any sound from the incoming train.
Excuse me, sir. Can you explain what has happened?
I don't know. It's as if the train vanished into thin air.
Holmes, say something.
Quick, fetch a lantern and let us take a look.
It's too dark. Only fog and rails, nothing else.
There is no use in stumbling around here at night. We will come back tomorrow. Well, here we are again at Evesham Station. We have a full day ahead. Let us begin our investigation. This suitcase contains my archives. We can consult with it if needed. It is fortunate that we took it with us. This suitcase contains my archives. We can consult with it if needed. It is fortunate that we took it with us. First of all, let us examine the area where the train disappeared. First of all, let us examine the area where the train disappeared.
What should we do next, Holmes? the place where we saw the train vanish last night.
A discarded item, possibly thrown from the train. Railway sleepers, nothing unusual. There are no tracks or footprints on the ground. The rails have not been touched. There's nothing unusual here. There are no signs to indicate that the train ran off the track, nor are there any other traces. There is nothing whatsoever. There are no clues. But then, a negative result is also a result.
Oh, I see what you're getting at. No clues, and you're smiling.
Yes, Watson, I do smile on occasion. This mystery appears very promising. This investigation won't be simple. We shall require a map of the region.
Perhaps the station master could lend us one.
Good morning. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my friend and colleague, Dr. Watson.
Yes, I remember you. I'm Station Master Everett. You were here last night. So, you are Mr. Holmes, the great detective. Will you be investigating what happened?
I shall indeed.
It is extraordinary that an entire train could disappear like that. And to think of all the poor people inside it, the passengers, the driver.
Could you please give us any details about the train?
Well, there was nothing so very special about it. At least not that I can recall. My memory's not what it used to be. However, if you need it, you can have the train composition report. It's inside my office.
I would be glad to have a detailed map of the local railway district.
But of course, please, take the one that's pinned inside the waiting hall.
See you later, my good man. Railway post bags.
Holmes, how is it even possible for a train to disappear?
This map will be useful.